JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for August the 13th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the market. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian morning Thursday. It lost the most versus NOK, SEK, CHF and the Euro in that order, while it underperformed the least against the British pound. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the yen. Now, the weakness of the US dollar and the Japanese yen suggests that risk appetite rebounded again yesterday. However, the fact that the Swiss franc was among the main gainers points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU and US indices were a sea of green, with the upbeat morale rolling somewhat into the Asian session today. Although Hong Kong's Hang Seng is currently down 0.24%, Japan's Nikkei 225 and China's Shanghai Composite Index are up 1.83% and 0.29% respectively. European shares may have received a boost yesterday after the US firm Liberty Global launched a takeover offer for the Swiss company Sunrise Communications in a deal valued $7.4 billion. In the US, Nasdaq rallied the most as Tesla announced a 5-for-1 stock split in an attempt to make its shares more accessible to employees and investors. The fact that US inflation accelerated by more than anticipated may have also fueled sentiment. Having said that, though, even if equities continue to gain for a while more, we prefer to take a more cautious approach as another day has passed without talks between White House and Democrats in Congress over a coronavirus aid bill. U.S. Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin said that the two sides may not be able to reach a deal, while House Speaker Nancy Pelosi noted that they remain far apart regarding any agreement. On top of that, on Saturday, top U.S. and Chinese officials are scheduled to meet and review the first 6 months of the Phase One trade accord. With tensions between the world's two largest economies flaring up again recently, it will be interesting to see whether the discussion will hit further hopes over additional progress. In our view, for investors to continue increasing their risk exposures, the Trump administration may have to agree with Congress Democrats over a new fiscal package, and US and Chinese officials may need to provide encouraging remarks over their nation's trade relationship. Back to the currencies, the dollar tumbled, although inflation in the US accelerated by more than anticipated. As we noted in the recent past, the US currency appears to be wearing its safe haven suit recently, and thus any data or headlines suggesting that the US economy was not hurt as many believe encourage investors to abandon safe havens in favor of riskier assets like equities and commodity-linked currencies. The opposite is true when developments undermine the broader investor morale. Now, as for today's events, the calendar appears relatively light today, with the only releases worth mentioning being Germany's final CPIs for July and the US initial jobless claims for last week. As it is always the case, Germany's final CPIs are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates, while the US initial jobless claims are forecast to have slowed slightly to 1.120 million from 1.186 million the week before. As for tonight, during the Asian morning Friday, China's industrial production, fixed asset investment and retail sales all for July are due to be released. Industrial production is forecast to have accelerated somewhat to 5.1% year over year from 4.8%, while fixed asset investment is forecast to have slid 1.6% year over year after falling 3.1% in June. Retail sales are anticipated to have rebounded 0.1% after falling 1.8%. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.